This is Alfie 2000 calling for Space Cowboy on station HUM-120. Respond if you copy. We have an update about your mission. This is Alfie 2000, Command Center.
This is Space Cowboy. I copy, sir. Proceed.
How are you holding up?
I'm getting by. It's tough, but I've trained for this.
Well, that's good. I will keep this short because I have important space commander stuff to do. We have decided to give you an assignment to do with your class you teach in hyperspace. Humanities, I believe it is, something about humans. We want you to give them three pieces of information that they should carry with them as you launch into, pun intended, as you launch into your discussion of the stories you are reading.
Okay, then.
The Brain Octopus Flesh Computer should be sending them right now. They will appear on your transmission screen. Good luck. Let me know if you have any questions. Over and out.
People ask me sometimes, when do you think it will be enough? When will there be enough women on the court? And my answer is, when there are nine.
Now here's our thought experiment. Imagine a computer programmer in a made-up world. Let's not crowd it with our knowledge and opinions about our world. So let's say this is a world similar to ours, but with different details. This is a thought experiment, so we're allowed to do that. This programmer is tasked with programming a computer system to give each person $3 when they push a button. Of course, the programmer has to define person and the programming language of the machine so that it knows when to dispense the money, right? So, of course, it's about whoever the programmer thinks qualifies because they're the ones setting up the definition in the programming, right? Now, let's say it's at a time in their history when some types of people are considered not human or not quite as human as others. For instance, maybe it's just the accepted norm at the time the computer is programmed that people who have two legs are not quite as human as people who have seven legs, which is the norm there. So when the programmer tells the computer, programming it in, you know, who to distribute the money to, they will program in people with seven legs. I mean, they're not being evil or nefarious. They're probably not even examining or questioning that. They just go, oh yeah, people with seven legs. All is well and good to those in the midst of that way of viewing the world, so he doesn't think anything about it, or they, she, whoever doesn't think anything about it as they're programming. Then over time, the society changes, as does its notions about who meets the criteria, or even that there should exist such criteria, and there is a leg awakening. Some people are all for it, and some are against such changes, but over time, the society does indeed change and realizes that people with two legs are just as human as those with seven. But, back to the computer. Unless someone deliberately and intentionally changes the computer program, it will still and always continue to distribute money to seven-legged people only. We could say all we want, that we have moved on, that we all agree that leg numbers should not matter. But the simple and clear fact is that the system itself does not adjust according to the changing values of the society that uses it. It must be intentionally and deliberately updated by a programmer. And until it is, it doesn't take any evil or ill intent for it to keep functioning as it was designed. It is simply a fact. Suppose I inherited a farm from my father, who suddenly died. He was in the process of farming and just keeled over. He had time to plant some corn, and that was it. Now, I've always thought about growing soybeans, so I'm like, here is my opportunity. I will use the land I inherited to grow soybeans and go sell them. But then I noticed that my father has already planted corn there. Dang it! Now I have to deal with this corn. I mean, I could ignore it and let it rot, or I could try to dig up the land and plant soybeans before it's too late, although there are some scientific and logistical problems with that plan. Or I can hire someone or sell the land as is to someone else so it's their responsibility to deal with, but no matter what, I inherited the land and the planted corn. It's already there. I didn't plant it, but I inherited it, and there's no getting around it. It is mine now. All the responsibilities and privileges and challenges of owning the farm are now mine, as is the natural consequences of my father having opened the ground and dropped some corn seeds into it. So it is not helpful to say, but I had nothing to do with that corn. I didn't plant it, I wasn't even here then. Very true. And yet, it landed in your lap, which is just a fact. All right, now none of those will make sense in the context of the class just yet, but I have followed my orders and I've laid out the groundwork. As we move through the discussion of these three stories, we will refer back to the quote, the thought experiment, and story time. So be looking for those.